So there's a certain sense in which mathematics is like poetry. It's a very, very refined, esoteric corner of the world. Now, from my point of view, also mathematics has a real, it's useful both as teaching, but also in all kinds of applications. And we don't get much recognition. If you are flying on a plane with somebody else and you say you're a mathematician, that ends the conversation.
Why math? You feel like you're doing something fundamental, the heart of things.
We always talk about mathematics as discovery versus invention. So some way of seeing the essence of things is there.
Just the most exciting subject that that I've ever studied.
I wonder if I can put it into words. It's impossible not to do mathematics. Mathematics is so beautiful and so compelling and so addictive. A life without mathematics would be dull.
The Mathematical Sciences Research Institute in Berkeley, California was founded in 1982 by three Berkeley professors, Hsing-Chun Chern, Cal Moore, and Isidore Singer. They envisioned a place where mathematicians from all over the world in a particular field could come together for intense periods of communication, collaboration, and contemplation.
The core mission of MSRI is to foster new research in math, especially in pure math. Time, real uninterrupted time to think, is very, very precious.
MSRI's special role is that it brings a lot of people together for a semester or a year. When I did a program here, a lot of things resulted. A lot of new ideas and new research came out.
The heart of what we do is bring people together and form communities that are all concerned about the same fundamental problems. MSRI hosts around 2,000 visitors a year, with periods ranging from a few days to an entire academic year.
To have a research institute where the people can come and do mathematics, it's a great idea to bring new results and new inspiration in mathematics.
MSRI has expanded its research mission with about 30 postdoctoral fellows a year coming to take advantage of the concentration of experts in their chosen field of study.
If you're a young person, you come to MSRI, you meet everybody that works on the same things as you are, so your research is bound to take off.
We bring them in contact with people that have felt it and really understand how it works and have that emotional engagement because they can transmit it. In 2008, Dr. Terry Tao, one of the most distinguished mathematicians of our time, participated in two of MSRI's programs. Dr. Tao is a Fields Medalist, a MacArthur Fellow, and a Fellow of the Royal Society.
I tend to work on problems that are just barely out of reach of the current technology, so that you have to just stretch a little bit, find one or two new tools to solve the problem. There is that moment that comes all the time in mathematics where you're trying to understand something which is very mysterious, and then when you see how it works, it just all clicks. It's really great to have places like this in mathematics. It's just the process of bouncing ideas back and forth with somebody else who completely understands all the issues. It's really quite fun. I wish I could jump 50 years in the future. All these problems which they're slowly making progress, but it would just be nice to skip ahead to the ending. I would love to see that, but I just have to wait.
In addition to its core activities, which serve the mathematics community directly, MSRI is involved in a number of outreach activities to reach the general public. We have a series of workshops called Critical Issues in Mathematics Education, where mathematicians and educators talk about fundamental problems. One of our collaborators, Hung-Shi Wu, at the University of California at Berkeley, runs a summer institute for middle school teachers.
The lining up of the decimal points.
The better the teacher of teachers, the better our future school teachers would be. And MSRI is in a unique position to do it, because if not MSRI, who would do it? The prestige and the implication of a research institution showing interest in school mathematics. That's a powerful combination.
Welcome to the club.
A little over 10 years ago, we imported an idea that had been popular in Eastern Europe, the idea of math circles.
The Berkeley Math Circle is an extracurriculum activity for a high school and middle school students.
These are four possible points, and then there's some more points up in a third dimension on the top layer of this cube, right?
My favorite part of the math circle, I'd probably have to say, is not understanding things, because it's always funner to try and figure them out later, and then it's fun to know, oh, I had to work at this, and I actually figured it out.
The past few years, with MSRI sponsorship, we've started some new math circles in San Francisco and Oakland, targeting unenriched kids.
What I like so much about math circles is that it's a way for kids to come together and focus on something they truly love. And they get to express themselves in a way that probably would not be possible in their school.
I think if people really appreciated the emotional side of mathematics, rather than saw it as formal strings of manipulations, then we'd see a lot more people appreciating mathematics the way they appreciate music. Our special projects director, Bob Osserman, organizes public events in the form of conversations with creative people from other fields.
Our first big outreach event was the Fermat Fest, when Andrew Wiles announced that he had solved Fermat's last theorem, which was the most famous problem in mathematics at the time.
Tom Lehrer, you know, the great mathematician, songwriter, he has a song called New Math, and he says, counting in base 8 is easy if you're missing two fingers.
MSRI has a lecture series sponsored by our Archimedes Society's Muséon Donor Group. The Muséon series has featured presentations by Nobel laureates Donald Glaser and Charles Townes, Don Knuth, Brian Greene, John Conway, Robert McPherson, Sir Michael Atiyah, Isidore Singer, and Ron Graham, one of the world's leading combinatorialists. MSRI has been working for some time to increase the participation of women and underrepresented minorities in mathematics.
We have uniquely brought together students, faculty from small colleges, and people from large research universities to actually listen to one another. We hope they'll come away feeling energized and empowered and not defeated, particularly if you are the only person or the only member from an underrepresented group.
Underrepresented minorities in this country includes African Americans, people of Hispanic descent, people such as myself, Native Americans, Asians and Pacific Islanders. And the fact that MSRI is interested in this issue, I think, is going to help others be interested in this issue and realize its importance for the future of mathematics in this country.
We might have 100 women majoring in mathematics, but we have less than 20 African Americans who earn the PhD degree in mathematics every year.
Graduate students are drawn to programs where they see black faculty and black staff, and that knowing that there's a sense of belonging here where students can find social and academic peer support.
So I had a good undergraduate education, but the thing that really got me through was more of a sense of determination in the support system to say, this is what I started to do, and really no matter how long it takes, I'm going to do it, and I did.
I decided to go to graduate school so that I can hopefully eventually get into teaching. It's very interesting to be somewhere where before I came, everyone's like, oh, you're going to MSRI, that's so prestigious. And you get here and it's just welcome. It's so welcoming. The people here at MSRI really want to help us make this difference in our community.
One of the ways that MSRI reaches out to underserved populations is through our program called MSRI Up.
Good morning. Welcome to the MSRI Up final presentations. The goal of the MSRI Up program is to identify talented undergraduate mathematics students from underrepresented communities and hope to motivate them to continue to graduate school by providing them with the research experience.
My goal was, at the beginning of this project, was to give you a problem that you could not solve.
One through K-1 specifically always seemed to branch on the left. It was a lot of work. I didn't sleep much, and I had no idea if I was even going to be able to cut it for 6 weeks.
Students of these groups do not see themselves as going to graduate school. This is the big problem, to give them the first step towards saying, I can do this. I can work in a serious problem. I can work with students of other groups, and I'm at the same level.
I was debating whether I wanted to go to grad school or not before. And after the 6 weeks, I'm feeling better. I'm not completely convinced. You're never convinced until you're there. But I'm going to give it a shot, for sure.
With continual funding from the National Science Foundation and other government organizations, private foundations, a family of academic sponsors that now numbers more than 90, as well as private individuals, MSRI has been able to move in new directions and develop new activities. We've also expanded our facilities, including a brand new auditorium and an enlarged library.
One of the big initiatives has been to try and build bridges between pure mathematics and applications of mathematics, bringing communities together to make new connections.
What this institute has a unique ability to do is respond very quickly to new problems by broadcasting out to the world, hey, we want to focus on, for example, climate change.
One of the immediate challenges that we face is predicting climate change over the next generation, next 25 to 30 years. And that's a problem where mathematics and climate science are inherently interwoven. We've had some very fruitful discussions here at MSRI about how to take initial steps at that synthesis.
The projection of future climate is a mathematical problem. That's it. It is not an observational problem.
Are the projected extremes from these climate models robust? We don't know the answer. We have many of the problems that we're talking about now won't be solved by my generation. They'll be solved by the next generation. And the critical role that MSRI is playing is in engaging those students and working with scientists on fundamental questions in energy, health, and society.
MSRI is an exciting place. It's an essential resource for the mathematics community, and I'm proud to be doing my part to help it continue in its grand tradition of nurturing new mathematical talent and exposing the public to what I think is some of the most beautiful work that's being done now.
It's a place where mathematicians feel that this is a home. It may be a home away from home, like an oasis within the mathematics community.
To have a place where mathematicians can get together and be ourselves and feel happy because there are other people who have common interests is just so important. There are a handful of places, and MSRI is the absolute crown jewel.
I think it can have a real impact on somebody to come here and just experience the power of mathematics and the power of their ideas, and that there's a whole community of people that they're part of that you often don't feel if you're in your university trying to understand some problem that's just very resistant. But here you feel connected with other people, your ideas get liberated, and you can just think further.